Hey, it's Michi here. So, I completed Inktober for the first time this year, and today I'm going to be flipping through all the drawings while talking about the thoughts that this challenge sort of brought up. I'm not going to talk about each individual drawing, I'll just quickly flip through them, lest this video becomes 2 hours long. But as part of the challenge, I did write a little bit about each drawing, like sort of journal style, on the back of the drawings every day, just to chronicle my experience with Inktober. Feel free to pause the video if you want to look at a drawing longer or read those journal entries. I'll even transcribe the writing if there's interest for it, because I know my handwriting's pretty garbage. But anyway, so Inktober. The challenge is to make one inked drawing every day for the month of October. And it doesn't have to be like ink at all. It could be anything you want, basically. It's cool seeing artists have do their own take on Inktober. I'm not following the official prompt list or any prompts for that matter. I'm just coming up with each drawing one day at a time. The only restriction that I placed on myself was that I prohibited fan art for this challenge. So all of these drawings are of original characters and concepts and whatnot. I pretty much exclusively draw fan art at this point in my life. It's what motivates me to draw, so I wanted to challenge myself to make more original content, just to see what I can come up with. I attempted Inktober a few years ago, but never finished it. I completed Inkuary once in 2019, which is basically Inktober but in January, since January was when I had my winter break from school, from university. So it's not my first time completing a month-long drawing challenge like this, but this is the first October when I'm not in school, which would usually keep me too busy to draw at all, let alone draw every day. I mean, the only reason why I can even do Inktober this year is because I have a lot of time on my hands, which, as a former overachiever, feels kind of weird. I'm just sort of existing right now. I'm sort of on a sabbatical type thing, I guess. I mean, without getting into too much detail, I haven't been in the greatest headspace these past few months, and I figured that Inktober would be a good way to allow me to be somewhat productive on something that I actually like, and just helps pass the time, I guess. It also helps me sort of escape, which I suppose is a good and a bad thing. It's always good to enjoy me time every once in a while and sort of ignore the world, but it becomes somewhat unhealthy when it's a constant thing. And it's kind of been a constant thing for me. Honestly, don't know what I'm gonna tell employers when I do go back to the job search, but it's okay. It's okay. I realized this when doing Inkuary for the first time, and I see it again this time. Drawing can be really isolating. There are a few hours of the day where I'm just unavailable. I don't look at my phone, and I basically don't talk to anyone. I just sort of focus on drawing. I think Inktober kind of fed the semi-hermit lifestyle I've been living. And drawing challenges like these always remind me of how much I don't want to pursue a career in illustration or art-related fields, because I cannot imagine drawing every day to sustain myself. I'd be so tired of drawing because I have to. Now, I'm sort of glad that growing up, I received a lot of backlash for even considering doing art as a living, because I think a career in art would have ruined drawing for me. I learned in college that not every passion has to turn into a living, and you don't always have to make money out of every hobby. You can just make something for the sake of it, or enjoy something purely for the sake of enjoying it. At this point, drawing for me is the only thing that's not tied to any financial or societal obligation. It's not associated with any external expectation or image, and it's something that I can turn back to whenever I want and sort of make whatever I want. And I know that sounds like incredibly selfish, but after many years of feeling like I always need to produce some kind of success or results for others, or living up to certain expectations that other people have of me, having something like this is, I don't know, sort of sacred to me. Okay, now when I say that, it sounds so deep and profound, but really I'm just talking about making dumb drawings of anime boys. I mean, it's not that deep. It's not that deep. But yeah, basically in hindsight, Inktober was fun, but there were many times where I was just done and I was like, shit, is this month over yet? And during last week, I really was counting the days down. Like, I was so over like a lot of the drawings. I'm definitely sticking to drawing purely as a hobby for now. Who knows? how my relationship with drawing will change in the future. I'm just lazy, guys. I'm surprised that I even managed to make it past day 5 because I'm a lazy artist. But Inktober's still fun. It was a good way to try out drawing different things, different poses, different expressions, and scenes that I wouldn't normally draw. I don't think my drawings really improved throughout the month, which initially gave me like a sort of knee-jerk panic. Like, shouldn't I be getting better as I draw every day? They say that drawing constantly helps you improve, but the amount of hours practicing doesn't always translate to the steady improvement you'd expect. Sometimes you stagnate, sometimes you even get worse. And honestly, I'm starting to learn that that's okay. I don't have to be constantly getting better. Sure, I wish I could be better at drawing certain things so that I can better translate my vision onto paper, but another thing Inktober has taught me to do is to say fuck it and let go and move on. Because of the time restriction, I had to be a lot more flexible, not only with my drawing ideas, but with myself. It forced me not to take any drawing too seriously, to just have fun with it. It doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be my best work. It's just, I just have to make a drawing and just go through with whatever sort of concept I have in mind. Once I adopted that mindset, probably about halfway through the first week, Inktober became a lot more bearable. But anyways, even if the drawing themselves didn't improve, the process itself on average became a lot faster as the month went on. I was pretty shocked sometimes at how quickly I managed to get a sketch done. So that's something, I guess. Inking's my favorite part of the drawing process, but I miss using colors and I miss drawing fan art. I actually had a few fan art ideas and some like WIPs from September that I thought, me being the clown I am, that I thought that I was gonna finish in between Inktober stuff. So this month I only managed to finish a quick drawing of Aoba from Dramatical Murder, which is funny because if you look at all the drawings I made this month all together, it's like a sea of gray, and then Aoba's just there with his bright ass blue ass clothes. Thanks for listening to my spiel. I hope you like the drawings. Even though I had all the time in the world to make these drawings, I'm still really glad I managed to complete the challenge. And I'm low-key glad it's over, though it feels so weird, like, not having to draw every day. I'm curious, which drawing is your favorite? My favorite is probably day 23. I think my line work was at its peak, and the character that I drew ended up being really cute. So yeah, thank you for watching, thank you for listening, and I'll see you later. Bye!